Every time I do triceps, I just think bigger bench press, bigger bench press. That's it. What's up, you guys? Pitbull Torres over here. I want to show you guys how to bench, some good cues I learned, how to get over a 400-pound bench press. In the podcast, we talked about like cues, and I used to always think bend the bar. They'd tell me bend the bar, and what I was doing was using too much of my tricep on the way down and not using enough of my back. And especially someone who has really mobile shoulders, like females, they have really mobile shoulders. You don't want to give that cue of tucking your elbows too much, because when you bench press, it's gonna look like this. So you get the bar, and if you tuck your elbows, look at my elbows, like you want your wrist joint to be stacked with your elbow, and this is a stacked position. Your body's just stronger in a stacked position. Like this, my wrist is now like going behind my elbow, making it awkward, putting a gang of tricep pressure on the tricep. So when I'm benching, I wanna think about, I'm opening up that red band. So obviously you can't open up steel, but I'm thinking about it. Now look where my elbows are at and my placement. Way more, I'm in a stacked position like Mark was saying, and then coming up. Oh, my back just cramped. Oh, my fucking lap, bro. That's like how tight you gotta get your back when you bench. That's like when I first started bench pressing, I would get back cramps all the time. Like, I used to bench just flat like this, chilling. I bench 405 like that, maybe a little bit like this. But I wasn't thinking about opening up my thoracic and my chest as much as I can. And it's gonna feel uncomfortable for you. Like, the first time you guys are like trying to really use your back, it's gonna feel like a back. You guys are doing chest, but it's gonna be feeling like you guys are doing a back workout, because the whole time you're trying to keep that back pinched as you press. What happens is people press and they lose it all. They're like this. So you need to make sure you're keeping that back pressed. No matter how far you press, you're not losing the scapular traction. You're keeping your scapula pinched back. You go down and you come up without losing that scap. That's why everyone messes up their shoulders, because as soon as you lose the pressure off your scapula, all the strain just goes on your shoulders or your triceps or your pecs. So making sure when you guys are warming up, like I said, with this red band, just like on the barbell. I mean, when I grab the barbell in my hand, I'm envisioning I could open it up and I'm pulling it back. And notice the band, I'm putting it right on my sternum where I would bench press. So we're talking about my elbow placement. Remember, I'm thinking about opening up that bar. Elbows, you notice they're not super tucked like this. I'm still using my back, but my elbows are not overly tucked. I would overly tuck and use too much on my tricep. So now I'm just thinking, use more of my back than my shoulders and triceps. Lats are so sticky, man.
Well, your lats are the reason, that's what keeps the bar close to you. If your lats ain't like warmed up, it's gonna be a hard time keeping those that bar close to you. And when you're lifting really heavy, if that bar gets that far away from you, it's gonna go in front of you and you're not gonna get the lift. So this helps me keep my lats more tighter. And same for bench, I just have more activation. Before I bench, we'll go over it right now. I honestly do probably like for somebody a whole back workout. I do about three to four sets of 12 reps. And I do chest supported rows, or some type of dumbbell row, just to get a lot of blood flow in my back. So when I start pressing, I already have that blood flow in my back. So I could just feel the activation a lot better. That's been a game changer doing that.
And then what device are you using here?
It's just a little vibration gun. It's like the brand's like Artist Day. Nothing crazy. Just helps some blood flow. Sometimes when you roll out, you know, it helps break up the muscle tissue, but sometimes this just helps get more blood circulation through the body.
So do you kind of roll first and then
yeah I roll out first, then I do this, because this is like, honest, this is like the lazy way of rolling out, I would say. So like, you can't depend on this, because this ain't gonna, you can't put your body weight pressure with a gun. It's gonna break, or it just can't do that much. That's good. So I always roll out first, then just use a gun for like a little bit of touch-up work. like I've done a lot of back workouts, so my lats and my serratus are super tight. Especially a lot of benching is gonna get your serratus tight. Your serratus is like on your rib cage, it's part of your lat. Your lat ties in from like your armpit all the way down to your hip. So believe it or not, like right now where I'm at, I'm rolling out my lat, and that's where I feel so much tightness and like my QL, like almost near my like lower back, and it goes all the way up. So I'll start here and just start slowly going closer to my lat. But like I'm saying, this is like on my rib cage, my serratus. And you just wanna breathe through all the hard, where you feel like you're freaking out, you just wanna breathe. And it's gonna just release all that tightness. And I'm telling you, once you get these lats to release, if you have tight lats, your power in them is gonna be stupid. Chest and my shoulders. So when I warmed up my lats right now, I hit the gun a little bit, it just feels like light, like no more weight.
It's crazy.
Yeah. Damn, that's a fat ass boy.
Do you feel like you should have been doing a lot of this stuff all along, or do you feel like you had to start doing this stuff as you continue to get stronger?
I felt like I should have been doing it all along. So like after a hard training session or a good workout, I would never stretch my lats, roll out. I never even rolled my lats until probably like a year ago. And like I've done so much back workout, like bodybuilding training, like heavy ass lat pull downs where I feel like I'm gonna rip my lat right here, and just done heavy bent over rows, 315 for 10, just stupid amount of back volume work, and never rolled out my lats. So, or got my lats worked on, so my lats just feel stupid tight, and that's why I'm having a hard time using my back when I bench press. And I have a strong back, I'm just having a hard time using it. So that's been my biggest downfall. But just, you know, still to kind of keep on practicing. I mean, obviously you gotta have strong shoulders, pecs, and triceps. A lot of people don't do enough close grip bench. I do a lot of close grip bench. I do a lot of dumbbell incline that builds your shoulders. So you gotta make sure you're doing those, because you can't just have a strong back. You gotta also have a strong push, you know. But that's majority of people have a strong push, they just don't have a strong back. Like, that's even in bodybuilding, the thing, what wins shows and what people neglect the most is their back, because you can't see your back. When you work out your chest, you can see your whole body, but you can't see your back, you know? So that's like the most neglected body part. So yeah, a lot of skull crushers, I'll do some isolation work for my triceps. I'm a big believer in just like, you need to do a lot of volume for like smaller muscles like that. I talked to Eric Spoto back in the day, like long time ago. And I remember everything on the podcast, like a long time ago, I think I'm talking about how he does like sets of 20 on triceps, everything high reps. So I've been a big believer on that. So I do heavy, but 20 reps, you know, not just light 20. I go heavy as I can for 20. So that's definitely triceps. Every time I do triceps, I just think bigger bench press. That's it. One thing I always do is I always pause it, because in competition, you gotta pause it. A lot of people train touch and go, and like you don't get to do touch and go in competition, so it's gonna throw you off. Like I used to be really good at touch and go, just like that was my shit. And then I'll go to meet and I'd be like, fuck, I can't do the same weight. Or I'll start pausing like a month out. But now I do sets of 10, pause, everything is paused, because that's how you gotta do in competition, so.
What's your best bench press?
441 in competition, and I've done 455 in like at the gym and stuff, but it was still paused. But 441 in comp, so I'm a long overdue for a bench PR. That was like, fuck, like 5 years ago I set that.
Oh, wow.
And that was at 181. Yeah, that was a long time ago. That's what I'm saying. I know I have the strength in me. It's more just the activation. Even just going up for two plates right there, that didn't feel good. Like just my having a hard time just feeling everything in my back. My bench has been stagnant, like legit been stagnant. And I know it's just, it has to do with my back, my lats being tight. Cause like I said, I've done 405 bench since I was 18, and I'm 28 now. And like I said, it has, my best bench is 455 or 441. So, and you would say like almost 9 years that it's gone up like you know, 30, 40 pounds. So, like, that's, like, the where I tell you, it's frustrating. You guys, they get frustrated. Like, you can't, you know. The new PR, man, I've been doing this shit for, like, 10 years and can't even get a PR on my bench. So, like, it's just, like, you can't give up. I said that on the podcast, too, you know. We're all easy to make an excuse. Oh, that's all I could get to was a 405 bench or, you know, like, there ain't no limits, you know. You got to push your limits and stuff. So, that's what I'm trying to do. So, I already know it's getting my body out of running at 100%, not 50%. So, I'm working on it.
What are some other mistakes you see people make when they're training their bench? Like, obviously you said that a lot of people are not training with the pause. What are some other things that you see that you think people
not training with the pause for sure? And then I would say, like, close grip benching is the best for building raw strength. Even these great low bar squatters at one point in their life, I'm sure they did high bar squats, because that's the only way you can you're getting more range of motion, you're stretching your muscles more, so you're gonna build more of your triceps, you're gonna build more of your shoulders if you're benching with a close grip bench. You're benching, why are you just using a shitload of your back? You're decreasing range of motion. So when I see these new lifters, I see a lot of people trying to, like, cut the leverages out, or, like, you know, go leverages and, like, showing the range of motion, where as a beginner you should go through full range of motion, build as much natural strength as you can, and then start, you know, learning the technique and trying to, you know, better your leverages and, you know, doing stuff like that. But the biggest thing, I think everyone just needs to do more, like I said, more range of motion squats, more range of motion deadlifts, and more range of motion bench press, because that's just how you build that raw strength, you know. There's like, let no arching, like, feet up bench press. I do a lot of that. I don't really use leg drive until I get closer to the competition. So, like, I'm just building a lot of, like, just, I call it raw strength, top end, like, just raw strength. That's it, man.